special in his tape. Chris Gentile, one of our female singers and dancers, got a nice tape, good easy listening tape, a good band, and she does a lot of Patsy Cline type songs. I've got two old tapes, just me and my piano, and one of them is a 60-minute tape with 35 old tunes on it, and the other one is a 30-minute tape with just waltzes and polkas. And you can buy those at either one of the souvenir stands whenever you
want
to do that. Also,
yes.
The Baldknobbers just got through back in the cassette tape. And if you like good country music, it's a beautiful tape, so be sure you pick one of those up. They got some good fresh hot popcorn back there, cold drinks, candy bars, hot coffee, hot tea, and some of the best lemonade gifts lay the lid on.
Just go.
If you need to see the manager, whatever it might be, just go back there in the corner and he'll be at the concession stand. I'll tell you what.
It's a music show. The Baldknobbers Jamboree.
Let's go.
Hi, Stubby. How you doing?
Oh, man.
Oh, what's wrong with you?
Oh, I got splinters in my hand.
Well, now, how did you get splinters?
I've been working all day.
Now, come on, man. What have you been working on?
I built a brand new outhouse.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Well, what happened to your old one?
Oh, I'll tell you about that after all. I'll tell you about the new one. I'm proud of it. I got it all built out of pine. Mm-hmm. Went over on one side, cut me a half moon.
Right.
Went over on the other side, cut me another half moon.
Yeah.
Went inside, cut me two full moons.
That's a two-over.
In case you have company or something.
Yeah, you might. Hey, Stubb, I want to know what happened to your old outhouse.
All right, I'll tell you. You know my brother?
Oh, yeah, I remember
him. He come in from all out there, you know.
That's a hand grenade.
I know what it is. Don't ever hold a man with a hand grenade in his hand.
Now listen, those things are dangerous.
It's safe. See that pin right there?
Do you ever pull it?
Do I look like I'm stupid enough to pull a pin on a hand grenade?
Right on, brother.
You pull that pin right there and you count to three real quick and you throw it. I had a 1 hour crash, of course. I know what I was doing. Pull the pin, 1, 2, 3, and I... And it went under the old outhouse.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Boards and shit going everywhere. But that wasn't the worst part of it, Gene.
Well, what was the worst part?
My grandma, you know, she's 90 years old.
Yeah.
She had the old outhouse when the hand grenade went off.
Oh, no. Stuff didn't hurt her.
Didn't help her. She didn't have a scratch on it.
Oh, that's good.
No, she come out there wiping dust and stuff off of her. She looked at me and said, "Woo, boy, I'm glad I didn't do that in the house."
Hey, that's not that old right there. You're leaving, and you'll be gone for good. But speak softly, you're talking to my heart. Love is a treasure that you can never find. I thought that I found the promise, dawn, but now it's over. It's all over. Only a fool would stay to watch it fall. Introduce you to the young man who opened our show tonight. Now he's one of Branson's hottest entertainers. Would you make welcome back to the stage, Mr. Dennis May?
Thank you. with a steel horn hat. Well, I could cry through a hammer and paint the things with my hands that most men can't. I can't get ahead no matter how much I try. I'm really good at barely getting by.
Thank you, Dennis.
Hey, Jim.
Yeah, what?
You know, branching off all the lights and activity going on. You know what it reminds me of?
No, what does it remind you
it
of?
It reminds me of down there in New Orleans, down there at that term,
Mardi Gras?
Mardi Gras,
yeah, that's right.
Down there on the Shoestring Street.
Yeah. No, stuff, that's Bourbon Street.
Not the way you tied one on it. Anyway. My daddy, he warned me about that term, Bourbon Street. Mm-hmm. He said, son, whatever you do, don't. Do not go on the Hoochie Goochie show. Stay away from the girly show. Because you might see something you shouldn't see.
Yeah, yeah. That's good advice, Doug. Yeah. Did you go in one?
The first one I come to.
You see something you shouldn't?
Boy, sure did, Jim.
Yeah, what'd you see?
I saw my daddy sitting on the very first floor.
Oh, Jeff.
Yo, Branson, they got a lot of things. You know, a lot of shows, you know, a lot of kiddie rides. You know, they got helicopter rides.
Oh, yeah, those are fun.
Yeah, me and my wife, we took one of them today.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, and the pilot, he said, today and today only, he said, I'll take you all up there, and if you don't scream or holler, won't cost you a dime.
Hey, that's a good deal.
Yeah, of course, you scream to holler, you know, you're going to have to pay.
Oh,
you know.
Yeah.
Well, I know my wife wasn't going to scream, you know.
Well, how did you know she wouldn't scream?
I taped her mouth shut. And you know me, macho stud.
Yeah,
I
was sure.
Gene, we got up there, about 3,000 feet.
Well,
way high. Up there. Oh, yeah, it's cold up there. I like to froze to death, you know. So I reached up on that helicopter way up there and turned that big fan off, you know. Well, things got hot and hurried in. Yeah. It didn't scream, though.
No.
The pilot did. He got that big fan started again. He tried every way in the world to make us scream.
We did.
Yeah, but I didn't scream. Oh, almost did right there at the last.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I didn't. Almost, but I didn't.
Well, now, what happened to make you almost scream?
My wife fell out of a helicopter.
She's okay, isn't she?
Oh, yeah, I bounced right back.
Well, Stubb, you and your wife still live up there at Ozark, don't you? They're on the old home place?
Oh, yeah, whole family. family lives over there. Grandpa and Grandma, they live on one side of it, you know. And my cousin and his new wife, you know. Yeah, they live on the other side now, you know. Every Monday morning, you know, everybody up there does the laundry, you know. Last Monday morning, I walked out in the yard and looked over, and the bride, she had done the laundry, you know. And she's hanging up her husband's clothes, you know, hanging up his underwear, you know. Just singing along, you know. She's happy. Yeah.
Well, what was she singing?
Sugar in the morning, sugar in the soul, old man.
Oh, yeah, I'm telling
you. I looked over, and Grandma, she done the laundry, too, you know. Yeah, and she's hanging up Grandpa's underwear, you know. And she sang her song just
like that. Really? What was Grandma singing?
Precious memories.
Young lady is no stranger to country music. She was raised up around show business. Her family started the Baldknobbers in 1959, and she's the third generation of entertainers on this show. She's a beautiful lady with a beautiful voice. Would you make welcome to the stage, Pretty Miss Joy Blue?
Thank you.
Here and your dressing room door was open just a little bit, and I happened to look in there and I seen you wearing a girdle. When did you start wearing a girdle?
Ever since my wife found another front seat of my car. Oh, we got celebrity.
Right there.
You don't recognize me.
No, I don't have any idea.
I don't know. You remember years ago when streaking was the fad.
Yeah, I remember that.
The end thing. That old boy right there, he's the one who invented streaking.
He did?
Yeah.
He invented streaking.
Yeah, that's it.
Stubb, how did he invent streaking?
Well, he went to the bathroom one morning, reached up to get a hold of the preparation H, got a hold of Ben Gay, and... Stand up.
No. Hey, Stubb, we was talking about your family there a while ago. You know, I happen to know that you and your wife have a rather large family of your own.
Oh, yeah. We've got 12 children.
12 children?
Yeah.
My goodness, why do you have so many children?
Yeah, it's because my wife, she's hard of hearing, Jim.
Oh, what does that have to do with it?
Well, every night when we go to bed, I'd say, you don't go to sleep or what? And she'd say, what?
Hey, hold it just a minute, Stubb. Come back here. I've got a job for you tonight. I want you to help me set the stage up for this next entertainer we're bringing out here. Now, he likes to sit down on a stool while he plays his guitar and sings. So what I want you to do is go back in the dressing room, find a stool, and bring it out here for me. Can you do that? Right now, I want to introduce you to the newest member of the Baldknobbers show. He joined us last year, and we're mighty proud that he did. He's a great entertainer, and we want you to make him feel welcome tonight. Here's Bob Lethbridge.
Well, I don't need your rocking chair. I don't need your rocking chair.
Stage to sing for you now. How about a great big hand for two pretty little ladies, Christian Tile and Kelly Manhood? To us all the way from Tokyo, Japan. And not only is he a great fiddle player, he's a real good singer, too. Right now, he's going to sing and play one of the prettiest fiddle tunes ever written. How about a nice hand for Mike Ito and Nathan Square?
Thank you, sir.
There beneath the sun,
seems to see her there. In her eyes, there's a light shining ever so bright, as she whispers a silent prayer. Every word we meet, keeping them so far apart. Only there she and tell the stars above. In her arms he belongs, in her prayers a stand, a undying soul.
Girl, that boy, you're full of wind. See, I ain't no good with you, but that's all.
piano player has been with this show almost as long as the Baldknobbers have been in business. For the past 27 years, he's been entertaining people, playing nearly every instrument known to man with every kind of music from bluegrass to classical. And we want to feature him right now on one of the most requested piano songs of all times. How about a nice hand for Howard Hale?
Compare.
Thank you very much.
Oh. It's good to have you here in the Ozarks, and we're tickled to death to have you at the Baldknobbers show. How about a nice hand for Joe's ragtime party before the show? Wasn't that fun? Isn't it great? Show, we got a few little goodies to show you. We have some 8x10 colored pictures of all the gang up here on the stage. If you'd like to have one, they're only $2. At intermission time, all the gang will be right down here in front of the stage, and we'll sign autographs for you, okay? The Baldknobbers have a brand new video, and we're really proud of it. All the performers on the stage are on this video, and it's just about the same show you're seeing here tonight. It has all the comedy, all the music, it's all on there. They're also available right over here at this stand. And there's a nice concession area out in the label in the lobby. And we also have most of the entertainers on the stage have their very own cassette tapes. And they're all good and they're all country, so you can check those out too. We have t-shirts, sweatshirts, all different sizes, all different colors, from the little bitty ones on up to the big ones. A lot of people like to have their t-shirts autographed. And we have special pens. We can autograph these shirts. It'll never wash out, so you bring them down, we'll sign them for you. And a lot of guys collect a lot of baseball and golf caps, and we have both of them. They're two-toned, they're embroidered, and they're about as sharp as you'll find, and we can autograph those too. And we have mugs and cups and ball knobber socks and all kinds of we even have ball knobber light-up yo-yos. They come complete with batteries, and makes a good souvenir to take home to the grandkids. You know you can't come to the Ozarks without taking the grandkids a little something. Has the Baldknobber logo on there, and they're normally $22.95. They're on sale tonight for $3. They are $3, and that's complete with batteries. You bring that, we'll autograph it for you, okay? Hey, we're not trying to push all this stuff on you, but if you want it, we've got it. If you don't, come on down. We'd like to shake hands and visit with you anyhow. While you're here in the Ozarks, we're going to take a little break. Restrooms are in the back, Coke and popcorn are in the back. How many people have never had a Goo Goo candy bar? I'll tell you what, they're the best candy bars in the world. I don't even like candy bars, but boy.
Thank you.
started, and my goodness, you've been a really good audience tonight. Hey, we have 18 tour groups with us tonight, and when I call out your group, we want to know where you're sitting, so make a lot of noise, clap your hands, wave at us, and let us know where you're at. How about Bob Kenny's travel from Sun City, Arizona? Goliger's travel. I don't know where they're from. Are you from Ontario? All right, Ontario, Canada. Yeah, okay. And we have the CPC number 4 from Tarzana, California. Okay.
I've got 6 out of 4.
Flamingo travel from Santa Rosa, California. The Branson Music Showcase. I guess you're from all over, right? Is that correct? Because they didn't say where from. So it must be all over. Okay. The 50 Plus Club from St. Charles, Missouri. Major Country Cattlemen's Association from Chester, Oklahoma. Mabelville High Class of 1951 from Arkansas. Go on, let's go. Oh my, this is... What was that? Hey, this would be a good one here. Please Go Away, tours from Kansas and Colorado. But don't go away. Turco travel from St. Paul, Minnesota. The Nixa Senior Citizens from Nixa, Missouri. Or is that Nixie?
Nixie,
Missouri.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Calvary Baptist Church from Sheridan, Arkansas. Bus driver and Sunday school teacher.
Bus driver and Sunday school teacher.
Convenience tour and travel from Shallotte and Wilmington, North Carolina. Shut up, Steph. Southgate Baptist Church from Springfield, Missouri. Bank of Eastman Golden Seniors from Eastman, Georgia. Benny Perry Tour Group from Tryon, Georgia. Oh, that could be Tryon. I'm not sure. GWRRA Chapter P from Water Valley, Mississippi. Senior Citizens Center from Boonville, Arkansas. All right. Hey, we want to thank all the bus drivers, tour guides, and tour directors for bringing these groups into Branson, and especially for making the Baldknobbers one of your stops. We thank you for that. And we also want to thank everybody who drove here in their own personal vehicle. So if you drove here in your own car, truck, or RV, give yourselves a big hand because you're really important to us.
One of the girls in the band was doing this.
And we have several people celebrating birthdays tonight. We want to wish a happy birthday to Lauren Burton from Jacksonville, Arkansas. And also, Stub Meadows' lovely wife, Faye Meadows, right down here, is celebrating her birthday, as are your sons, Brian and Joe Meadows, and your daughter, Lori.
Yeah.
Well, all your kids were born in April, huh?
Yeah, I leave home July and August.
Oh, my. Oh, and a happy birthday to Evelyn with Goliger's Travel from Ontario, Canada. Happy birthday to Irene Duvonder. And a very special happy birthday to Rosa Adams. Rosa is celebrating her 93rd birthday. Happy birthday to Marge Jordan, and happy birthday to Harold Bird from Quincy, Washington. And now page 2. Now we're getting into anniversaries now. A happy anniversary to Ray and Jenny Iberg, also Opal and Ira Iberg, and they are brothers and I assume sister-in-laws. And they have been, both those couples are celebrating their golden wedding anniversary, 50 years of wedding. Margie and Glenn Jordan have been married 48 years. Congratulations. Dennis and Sylvia Knuckles are celebrating their 25th wedding anniversary, their silver wedding anniversary. Jerry and Ruth Simon are celebrating 46 years married. And we have Mr. and Mrs. Ray Tyson here, and they are on their honeymoon.
Are they doing good? Yeah.
Watching the show, Scott. We have some special people here with us tonight we'd like to recognize. We have Monica and Chris Bosseff, and they are all the way from Bucharest, Romania. It must be. Mickey Miro is a foreign exchange student from Cordoba, Argentina. And we have Janice Moody with us. Janice is with KTXR Radio in Springfield, Missouri, a fine radio station. The gentle time, I like listening to KTXR. And we have Lisa Moore here, and Lisa is with the editorial staff of the National Geographic Magazine. You got something there for me? Oh, you got it. Okay. Yeah, you do. Hey, welcome everybody there. And I've seen a lot of familiar faces tonight, a lot of our good friends and local people. You've supported the Baldknobbers for many years, but I'll not try to mention all that. I might forget somebody. But thanks for coming out and seeing the Baldknobbers. Now we're going to get on with the second half. Here's Mike Ito and San Antonio Road.
Deep within my heart lies a dead river, the song of old Santa Claus, where he dreams to live with a memory beneath the stars alone. It was there I found beside a road, enchantment stranger the blue. Here's my broken song of love. Moody always dreamt her in those holes in my heart. Go back, I won't roll the sand. This is sweet and I guess for you. Speak once again, oh my love, my own broken song.
Together for Pretty Miss Joy Blue.
Did you kiss me when he left? o'clock. Do you know?
For about a year and a half now. Don't you think it's time you went out and bought some new clothes?
Well, I bought a brand new outfit here.
You did?
Yeah.
Why don't you have them on?
Well, I hooked a team of horses up to the wagon, you know, and I hauled a load of hay up at the Ozark feed mill, you know, not too far from my house. You know. And after I got the hay unloaded, I looked, my old clothes is pretty well torn and tattered,
yeah,
you know. So I thought, well, I'll go over here to General Store and buy a new outfit, you know, and surprise my wife, Faye.
Oh, you're going to surprise old Faye.
Poor old Faye. Yeah, she was raised real poor, you know. She never did have nothing.
Oh,
I was the best thing that ever happened to her.
You have my sympathy, honey.
Me too. And so I went over to General Store, and I bought me a brand new shirt, new overalls, socks. You don't hardly ever wear socks. Yeah. You know, Rogan boots, you know. I had a pair of patent leather boots.
Oh, you did?
Oh, yeah. Leather on top, feet patent out the bottom. You know. I bought this new Brogan, you know, and I was going to surprise poor old Faye. You know. So I started home, you know, had my clothes right there in the wagon next to him in the box. You know. And I got almost home. Bull Creek runs right there from the house, about a mile there.
Yeah,
so I thought, well, you know, I hadn't had a bath in about 2 months, you know. So I thought, well, I'll take me a bath before I put my new clothes on, you know, surprise poor old Faye, you know. So I just pour my old clothes off and throw it right out in the middle of the Bull Creek, you know, right on down the riffles and land, you know. So I was out there, you know, had me bar soap, take me a bath, you know. Something happened, Gene. I don't know what, but something spooked the horses. And they run off with my brand new clothes in the wagon. Well, I stood right in the middle of Bull Creek, you know. I was clean, but I didn't have nothing on.
Well, Scott, what'd you do?
I just went on home, surprised old Faye anyhow. Her mother was there.
I was there too. Hey, Stubb, I'm surprised you let those horses get away from you because I happen to know that you're a very good horseman. Yeah, you ride horses all the time.
Yeah, no, I've rode my last horse.
Oh, you have?
Oh yeah. The last one rode almost killed me. Uh-oh. Yeah, dead.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. We was running along there, you know, and went to bucking, you know, and the saddle turned. I was underneath him, you know, and he's kicking and stomping me. You know. I began to think he didn't like me.
No.
Working me over, you know. My whole life just flashed in front of me. I thought I was a goner.
Well, how'd you ever get off that horse?
The manager at Walmart came out there and plowed me.
And now, once again, here's Christian Pyle and Kelly Van Hoon.
All those who are talking about this. That's true.
Everybody's going out and having fun. I'm just a poor boy staying home and having none. I can't get over how you make me feel. He's not like me, he's out fancy free, flirting with the girls with all his charms. I still love him so, and brother, don't you know, I'd welcome him right back here in my arms.
Somebody just to come up here and have a good time with us.
You're going to help him with a real pretty song called She Thinks I Still Care.
She thinks I still care.
hillside. Ask a friend about her. Just because I spoke her name somewhere. Just because I rang her number by mistake today. I still need her. Then let that a silly notion bring her cheek. Oh, would she ever be so free? Tell me where did she get such an idea? Just because I haunt the same old person where the memory of her lingers everywhere. Just because I'm not the happy man I used to be. I still need her. Then let that a silly notion bring her cheek. Oh, how could she ever be so free? Tell me where did she get such an idea? Just because I spoke her name somewhere. Just because I rang her number by mistake today.
Songs that was made famous for the legendary Ray Price. I hope you like our version of them. Well, I couldn't sleep last night, just walked the floor. Blue. there. Even tell my friends I'm glad when you don't call. But when the day is through, my heartache's starting new, that's when I miss you most of all. Oh, yeah, just who was it?
Grandpa, Grandma.
Come on, I'm serious. Hey, is there anybody else in here tonight who wants to hear Stubbs sing? Well, all right, I guess we'll let you do one. Have you got something picked out for him?
Yeah, this is a tribute to the king of country music, the late Roy Acuff.
Here we go.
Bring me in our master brother, Roger. Yeah.
the hardest things you got to look way down deep.
Second place won't get it, son, so if I got to come in first.
Oh, there's nothing worse than to take the drink that leaves you with the she'll be there to let you know when the whole world does it wrong. There ain't nothing like a good lover, and that's how it's meant to be.
Well, find yourself a good woman, something like you want to be.
Yeah,
big, big,
big, big, big, big, big,
big, big, big, big, big, big, big, big, big, big, big, big, big,
big, big, big, big, big,
big, big, big, big, big, big,
don't be fooled by money stream. Be careful where you dream. Life is what you make it. Sometimes you just can't win.
If you want to get to the promised land, you better be deeper in the well.
Deeper in the well.
Deeper in the well. If you want to get to the
water, you've got to dig a little deeper in the well.
Hey, somebody better help him out. Yeah, hey, Trooper George, take over for him. I'm sure.
Yeah! Oh, no! Oh, you're a lot of help. I bet it takes you an hour and a half to watch 60 Minutes. Oh, gee!
Well, what's wrong now?
Oh, no. I never noticed that before.
You never noticed what before?
My socks don't match. I was going to tell you, the other day, me and Droopy George, we went fishing down here on Lake Tatecomo.
Yeah.
We took our girlfriends, the Hershey twins.
The Hershey twins?
Yeah, one of them's plain, the other one's nuts.
Hey, which one did you get?
I got the plain one. I got the right one, baby.
We rented us a boat. Well, we had to rent a boat. My yacht was being painted at the time, so we rented the boat. Gene, we got out there, big hole of water, you know. Every cast is catching one, sometimes two at a time.
Oh, you caught a lot of fish, huh?
Oh, a lot of fish, yeah. The Droopy George, he said, pardon me, stop.
He did.
Did you have any gray poop on? I looked, I didn't see it.
Yeah, no, no.
Mud on the shoes. Group said, hey, we ought to mark his spot here so we can find it the next time we come back fishing.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah, so I got a Crayola off of it, put a big X in the bottom of the boat. He said, that's stupid. I said, what? He said, the way you mark his spot here. I said, what's wrong with that? He said, we might not rent the same boat the next time.
That's right. You knew all along, didn't you, buddy?
Hey, I may be stupid, but I ain't smart.
Right.
Oh, Gene, yeah. Sad deal, buddy.
Oh, really? Well, tell me about it.
Lost my mother-in-law the other day.
Well, I'm sorry to hear about that.
Yeah, she's yakking in the sky. But she left me $10,000 to buy a stone with.
Oh, well, that's nice.
Yeah. So I took the $10,000 and I went out and bought a stone with.
Well, you're a very thoughtful person, Stub.
What do you think of it? Said, if I didn't take that $10,000 and buy a stone with it, she's going to dig her way out and come back and haunt me.
Uh-oh.
I fooled her.
Oh, yeah.
Buried her face down.
And now, once again, here's Bob Lester.
You know, I've been listening to country music on the radio ever since I was just a little bitty kid. And I remember tuning in to my favorite country music stars, and I tried to imitate everything these guys did. I tried to sing just like them. And we're going to do some of those for you right now. And I remember one guy I listened to all the time. Now, this guy always dresses in black.
Johnny Pride.
His name is Johnny Cash.
Are you worming?
No.
Yeah.
keen arms of a rifle. The truth is entering.
Persecutions.
It's called impersonations. I didn't know you did any.
Oh, yeah. Hey, you can't name a movie star or a country and western star that I cannot impersonate.
Just do all of them.
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what, boys, that's not a bad idea. We'll let you do one, but I get to pick it out, all right?
Okay. Make it a hard one, though. I'll do those easy ones with my lips shut.
Well, I think we're good. Let's see. I'll get one.
That's sushi for supper. Looks like one of the little fellas lived.
Hey, I've got a good one. Let's see you imitate Lassie.
Hey, watch, you act like a tree and I'll try it.
Heroes had his own show a couple of years ago right here in Branson, right down the road, and his name is Willie Nelson. The old Willie, he's got a guy that comes in and helps him sing a lot. His name is Waylon Jennings. The old Willie and Waylon, they've had a lot of hit records together. We're going to do a Willie Nelson, Waylon Jennings duet for you right now. We're going to do them both at the same time, so you got to listen close, all right? And I'll tell you this, old Waylon's going to start off singing first. Here we go.
The finest duets in the country right here on our show. And we want to bring them out and let them do some of the old country duets for you right now. Ladies and gentlemen, here's Joy Blue and Dennis Mabe.
In a pawn shop in Chicago on a sunny summer day, couple days of sands, wedding rings there on display.
Well, she smiles and nods her head, and he says, honey, that's for you. Well, it's not much, but it's the best that I can do.
Golden rings, with one tiny little star waiting there for someone to take it home by itself. It's just a golden tiny thing, only love can make a golden.
You always said someday you'd go to live in Southern California. But me, I'd stay right here in Tennessee. You always talked about days in Southern California. But if you'll stay in Tennessee, I promise there will be better days with me.
I'm saying we both live in a two-story.
quality shop in Chicago on a sunny summer day. A couple gazes at the wedding rings there on display. Go.
With the Orange Blossom Special, here's Mike Ito.
OBS Syndrome. Oh, yeah.
People to put on a production like the Baldknobbers show every night, and you've seen all these entertainers up here working real hard all night long. But there's two other people that you haven't seen on stage, and that's because they work behind the scenes for us, and they do a great job. Now, the first one I want to introduce to you sits all the way in the back of the auditorium, and he's our sound and lighting director, Dean Billingsley. And then out in the lobby before the show or during intermission, you might have met our general manager, and his name is Max Tate. Give him a hand. These next two gentlemen are mighty important to the show. They are the owners and operators of the Baldknobber Corporation. Ladies and gentlemen, Jim and Bill May. That is our favorite time of the show. Here's our...
Hallelujah, I'm ready. Hallelujah, I can hear voices on the door. Hallelujah, I'm ready. Hallelujah, I'm ready to go. Been the symbol of freedom and justice in our country. Many young men and women have fought around the world to protect the precious rights that the flag represents. We believe that the flag should be held high in a place of honor by all Americans. And so with this song, we'd like to pay tribute to the grand old American flag.
Brother, look out me that you burned your flag. You don't need it. But I love what she stands for, and buddy, you better be with it. Well, I'm not too sure that burning the cloth is a crime. Well, I know you burned your flag, but I'm sure glad you couldn't burn mine.
My flag flies in my heart. It's not just the rag that came off this lady. Each man must take what he thinks and must live in his time. But I know you burned your flag, but I'm sure glad you couldn't burn mine.
Preacher, we all have the right to be heard.
glad you couldn't burn mine. But it's funny that burning a symbol could cause such a flash. All of the wars that we fought have been about that. We'll fly the flag so high that it's out of your reach. While we're about it, we'll use the freedom of speech. My flag flies in my heart.
A good time tonight. Now on your way out, if you'd like to have a souvenir, the souvenir stand back in the lobby is still open. And be sure and come back and see us this
Lord, come to you, come out to hear Jesus. does it all the time. But it's not my thing.
Yeah.
On occasion.
I love the Rocky Horse on your door.
Oh, I got that at a craft fair a long time ago. A friend of mine and I were at a little craft fair, and she says, "Oh, that's too wide for your door." And I said, "No, I've never had anything wide enough."
That was
so it worked. But the hail knocked the paint off of our house. And so we're going to have our house painted.
I didn't realize you were recording me.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you. right.
We work
cross, get no pay. I-ho, 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 I-ho.
This is a song that we end.
Oh, you
Yeah.
Ha ha ha.